Hello friends, welcome to CABPD tutorials. In this class we are going to learn how to draw the septic tank in AutoCAD in a very simple manner. Now let's go to AutoCAD. Before starting with the drawing, let's know about the components and dimensioning part of the septic tank. It consisting of 200 mm thick PCC at the bottom. Okay, and it will be provided with a bed slope of 1:20. Then there will be two walls on either side. At the bottom, this thickness will be 300 up to a depth of 600 mm. After that, the thickness reduces to 200 mm. At the top, RCC roof slab will be provided. It's of 75 mm thick. And for ventilating purpose, a pipe is provided which is of dia 40 mm. And this septic tank is provided with two pipes. One is for inlet, another one is for outlet. It's of 100 mm dia. And here also, here 40 mm thick Babel slab is provided. Now here inside the septic tank, the liquid will be up to a depth of 1400 mm. And we said that bed slope will be of 1:20. 1:20 is nothing but for every 20 horizontal, there will be one vertical. Now our inside dimension is 2000. So the vertical depth will become 2000 divided by 20. So we are going to get 100 units. Let's talk about that in detail while we are drawing. Let's start the drawing. Set the units, UN, enter. Select decimal, 0.00 precision, and millimeter as units. Click OK. Now select the rectangle command. Click here, D enter, and provide the internal dimension of 2000 by 900. Click. Now select this rectangle and click on the offset command. Provide the offset of 200 mm and click it outside the rectangle. Now select outside rectangle and provide a offset of 100 mm and click outside. Again, select the outside rectangle, provide an offset of 100 mm and click enter. Now press escape. Select all these rectangles and explode it by pressing X enter. Now select this vertical line, click on the offset command and provide an offset of 400 mm. And click to the right. Then again select this vertical line and provide an offset of 40 mm and click here. Now press escape. Now select the circle command. Now go to the midpoint of this vertical line, and here the pipe will be of 100 mm diameter, so the radius will be 50 mm. Type 50, enter. Now select this circle and click on the move command. Select the right side quadrant point as the base point. Now move to the left and click on the midpoint of the vertical line. Now select this circle and take the offset command and provide an offset of 10 mm and click inside the circle. Now select the line command. Draw a line from the quadrant point. Okay, draw an horizontal line here. Now press escape. Now select this horizontal line and click on the offset command. Now select draw option and again select multiple option and click on the vertical quadrant points here. Okay, click. Now press escape. Now in the home ribbon, tab, under the draw panel, you are going to get a spline pit option. Select that one and turn off the ortho mode and go to the end of these lines and draw one curved line here. Click here and click here and click at 1 point, 2 point and 3 point. Click and press enter. Okay, now select these lines and by holding the shift button in the keyboard, select these two lines and change the line pattern to dashed line. Okay, press escape. Now select these lines, click on the copy command and click on the top quadrant point here. Now turn on the ortho mode and move to the left side vertical line and paste it here. Now select these lines and click on the mirror command, click on any vertical line and move your cursor towards upside or downside and click. Now it is asking whether we need to erase the source object or not. Click yes to erase the source object. Okay, now we got the geometry. Let us hatch this portion. For that, go to the hatch command. Now select the double line pattern and click on the double line pattern here. Click here and again select this portion, this portion. Now adjust the scale here. Here there is a scale option. Now adjust the scale. Okay, since it is closely packed, I want more space, so I'm going to increase the scale. So press and hold the up arrow button. You are going to get the increased scale. Okay, now it's okay. Close it. Again press space bar to repeat the hatch command. Now select the sand pattern here. Come below. Okay, here it is a sand pattern. Select it and click on the outside box. Click here also. Then click here. Then click here. Now the sand pattern is not visible, nothing but it is provided with a more space. So we need to decrease the scale. So press and hold the down arrow button here. You are going to get the decreased scale. Okay, now close it. Now we got the plan of the septic tank. Now let us draw the sectional elevation of the septic tank, which is drawn through the section AA. Okay, for that I'm going to make use of the construction lines, and in order to differentiate these construction lines with the normal regular lines, I'm going to make use of different color for the construction lines. First go to the properties panel and change the color. Now for the construction line, go to the command and type XL for the construction line. Press enter. Here you are going to get different options like horizontal, vertical, angle, bisect, offset. Now select the vertical option and click on these vertical lines here. Okay, click on this vertical line. Okay, here also. Then here also. Okay, now cancel it. Again press space bar. Now select horizontal and click anywhere here. Now again cancel it. Now select this horizontal construction line and click on the offset command and provide an offset of 75 mm. Click 75 and click it below. Again select this bottom line and provide an offset of 300. Press enter. Now again select this bottom line and provide an offset of 1400. Press enter. Again select this bottom line and provide an offset of 200 mm. Click enter. Now select this bottom line carefully and provide an offset of 600 mm and click enter and click it upwards and close it. Now I am going to change the color in order to draw the normal regular lines. Now take the rectangle command and draw a rectangle from this intersecting point to here. Okay, again press space bar. From the second intersecting point, draw a rectangle up to here. Okay. Now again, press space bar. From the third intersecting point, draw a rectangle up to here, second horizontal line. Now again, press space bar. From the first intersecting point at the top, draw a rectangle from here to here. Okay. Now select these pipelines and select the copy command and select this point as the base point and move it below and click on this which horizontal line? Third horizontal line. Okay, click here. Now we got all the lines. Now press escape. Now select all these construction lines and delete it. Okay. Now take the trim command, right click. Now trim off this portion and as well as this portion also. Now select this wall portion along with the pipe and click on the mirror command. Now go to the midpoint of this rectangle or a horizontal line and click it and drag the cursor upwards or downwards. Click and press enter. Now select the construction line, Excel enter. Okay, before that I am going to change the color. Type Excel enter. Now select offset command and provide an offset of some 100 mm. Now select this line and click it this side, left hand side. Now press escape. Now select the pipeline here and click on the mirror command. Okay, now it is asking for the base point. Now track the end point of this bottom line. Okay, track the end point of this bottom line and click it here. Turn off the ortho mode and press tab button in the keyboard and provide an angle of -45°. Carefully observe, tab and provide -45° and press enter. Again press enter. Okay, now select this construction line and delete it. Now in order to complete this lines, go to the jumper command here. Okay, now select multiple option. Now click on the first line, first top line and the first left line. Okay, next second line and second line here, next third line and third line, next fourth horizontal, next fourth vertical. Okay, press escape. Now take the line command and draw one line here from the end point of the bottom line pipeline. Okay, I'm going to change the color first. Select the line, go to the end point and draw a line here. Press escape. Okay, now we need to draw the bubble slab here. In order to draw that one, we need to provide an offset of 150 and 300. Now I am going to select this line and click on the offset command and provide an offset of 300 and click it below. Again select this line and provide an offset of how much? 150 mm and click it above. Okay. Now select the construction line XL, select it. Now select the vertical option and click on this vertical line here. Press escape. Okay, now take the line command, rectangle command and draw one rectangle from this intersecting point to this point and press enter. Okay, now delete these construction lines and delete this bottom line as well as the top line. Okay, Now we got the Papal slab here, which is 150 mm above the line and 300 mm below the line. Now let us draw the ventilating pipe. Okay, for that I am going to select this Papal slab and click copy. Select any point as the base point, turn off the ortho mode and paste it here somewhere near to it. Now it should not be this much too long. Now select this one and click on the midpoint of this horizontal line. Now keep the ortho mode on, reduce the length. Okay, I will reduce it to somewhat this much. We can reduce it further. Okay, press escape. Now take the trim command, TR, double enter. Now trim up these lines. Again, trim this line. Okay, now trim this line also. Okay, escape. I already said the bed slope provided is 1:20. And the internal dimension between these walls will be of 2000 mm. So 2000 is horizontal, here 20 is horizontal. In order to get the vertical dimension of this slope, divide 2000 divided by 20, you are going to get 100. Now take the line command and draw one vertical line here of length 100 mm. Now move to the left and click it here, join it. Press escape. Now select the trim command, right click and trim off this line. Okay, now we got the geometry. Let us hatch this portion. Now go to the hatch command and select sand pattern here. Now click on the top RCC roof slab as well as bottom thick PCC. Now press close. Again press spacebar to repeat the same command and now select the double line pattern. Okay, now click on these walls. Okay, and adjust the scale. Here I am going to increase the scale by press and holding the up arrow button here. Here you can clearly observe the increase in the scale. Okay, I will adjust the scale, then close it. Here the outlet pipe will be of 400 mm vertical depth. So for that, what I'm going to do means I'm going to take a construction line, XL, enter, and select offset command and provide an offset of 400 mm and select this horizontal line and click it below. Press escape. Now select this vertical portion of the outlet pipe and press S enter to stretch it. Now select this end point and stretch it vertically and click on this horizontal line. Here you can observe the length is reduced. Okay, now select this construction line and delete it. And here there will be a liquid storage. If you want, you can hatch this portion also. Now go to the hatch portion. Okay, now let us take a dash pattern here. Search for the dash pattern, click here and click it inside. Okay, once you get that one, you can adjust the scale. Okay, now I want to show the transparency here. I will set the transparency to some 50%. Okay, now close it. Now we got the sectional elevation of the septic tank, which is drawn through the section AA, and here is the sectional plan. Remaining part will be dimensioning part as well as labeling part. Please check the comment section below this video to get access to the drawing file which I used in this video, and moreover, thanks for watching.